So with the help of Hashem, we're continuing with the inspiration for Purim. And one of the big things that we're learning, one of the big things we're learning in the introductions of the Arizal for Purim is called the Dormita. What is Dormita? Is the time of the sleep. Okay? Meaning, we know when Hashem created Adam, so there was Adam and Chava were connected, right? Zachar v'nekeva b'ra. Afterwards, Hashem wanted to make Chava to be existence for itself. So, ויפל השם אלוקים תרדמה על אדם. השם put Adam to sleep. That's called Dormita. In the time of the Dormita, when Adam is asleep, so then Hashem, ויבן השם אלוקים את הצלע. השם is building חווה. Right? So the Arizal takes that understanding and he says, this is what happens within every stage of our existence. Whenever we want to get from one level to the next, we have to go through a process like that. We have to go through Dormita, going to sleep, spiritually, also physically we have to go to sleep, but spiritually, and that sleep builds up the next level.
It's connected with the
Yerida. You can say that it is the same idea of going down for the purpose of coming up. So, yeah, you can say that. Wow, that's nice. Okay, so that's a very big understanding. It's a very important understanding. Many times, people are going through some kind of a crisis. They feel by themselves, they feel that Hashem is not watching them, Hashem doesn't care about them, they don't feel the divine providence over them, and so on. It's very difficult to live like that, almost impossible. How can a person live when he feels that he's not connected to Hashem? To be connected to Hashem is the whole, that's what we're here for. If we don't have that, so who wants to live a life when he's not connected to Hashem? So this is like the worst kind of life, the worst kind of feeling, the worst kind of what else can we say? That's all of the negative things are a result of that. Why people are doing sins? Because that they feel that Hashem is not with them. Someone that he feels that Hashem is with him every moment, how can he make a sin? How can he make something negative? All the negativity is coming from that, right? So with this idea that we just explained from the introductions of Purim, obviously it's not only about Purim, this we speak a lot about it also as preparation for Rosh Hashanah. This is the idea of the Dormita, that there is a certain kind of sleep, which means in the Kabbalistic terms that the light disappears, goes up to the heavens, goes back to its source, and the vessel is empty, right? Here I have a full cup, but if that cup was empty, so I feel I don't have what to drink. It's empty. I don't have I feel thirst and I don't have anything to drink. So very, very hard kind of situation, right? Many things like that, obviously.
The Dormita of Purim,
yeah, that's what I said yesterday, that generally the understanding of the Kabbalah is that all what had happened in the past, the reason we make it to be a holiday because that existence, that reality, spiritual reality, is coming every year again and again.
In which part it exists in this Dormita?
Okay. That needs an observation. I'm not going to answer that right now. But what I want is to give over the principle. The principle is that when we feel empty, when we feel that our neshama is not with us, we don't feel Hashem, we feel that we have certain needs that they are not getting fulfilled. So all of those things, it means that we are in a certain level of dormita. And that means that the next thing will be building chava, building the unity, building the next stage of our life, our existence. And the same thing that we say about the individual, the same thing about the global. Okay? So many people, they are very worried today about the situation of the world, the pandemic, and all kinds of wars, and all kinds of whatever. There's many, many people that are worried about many things. What's the answer? It's dormita. There's a certain level that needs to build up. And for that process of building that next level, so we experience something that is, it feels very negative. So we have to strengthen ourselves that it is not that nothing is happening. The result of all what we're going through now, it means that the next level that is getting built up is very big. As much as there's more time of sleep, then the next level will be very, very big. And going back to Purim, the whole story of the Megillah happened, like I said yesterday, after 7 years of exile, right? So there was first 70 years of exile, and then it got to be very, very stressful in that point, just before the redemption, just before building the new Beit HaMikdash. You can look at it. You can look on everything in different angles. Okay, people that they want to feel the sweetness of the redemption right now, and they have all kinds of problems and affliction. Okay, you're right. It's difficult, but when we know that there is a purpose for all of that pain, all of that suffering, all of that long, hard process that we're going through, there is a purpose. And the purpose is very, very big, very, very meaningful, something that will fulfill the whole world with light and revelation of Hashem. So when we look on that, so it should give us the strength to get over that stage and to have the patience that is needed, Bezrat Hashem, to see the awakening that is coming after. Bezrat Hashem. Baruch Adonai l'olam, amen v'amen.